गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडेस वीडियो इज अबाउट ऑपरेटर्स इन सी एंड टुडे लेट अस सी अबाउट द लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स इन सी, लॉजिकल, रिलेशनल, बिटवाइज, ऑल दिस। ओके, सो लेट मी बिगिन विद द रिलेशनल ऑपरेटर। सो रिलेशनल ऑपरेटर इज नथिंग बट दैट रिलेट्स वन वेरिएबल विद द अदर। A variable that relates with more than one variable is called as relational operator. Let us see what are the different types of operators in relational operators. We have equal to when we check the equality between the two variables. At that time we use this double equal to sign, not equal to exclamation and equality sign together. Greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to. This I will be explaining with the help of a small C program. Let us go to the C program now. Yes, so what are we doing over here is, we are checking the relation between the two variables. Here I have considered three variables A, B, and D, and there I'm applying the combination of the relation and the logical operators in between them. So let us see how it works. So before going to the program, let us understand the logical operators as well. Logical operators are those operators which works behind some logic, and those are logical AND, logical OR, and logical NOT. Here logical operators purely work on the truth tables. Truth tables like logical AND, it works when both the variables A and B are true. That time only it will be, the result will be true, otherwise it will be false. And logical operator OR is, it is true when both the variables A and B are true. If at all any one of them is also true, the result will be true. If not, if both of them are false, then the result is false. And logical AND, logical NOT is nothing but the reverse of the variable A. If A is 0, then the NOT A will be 1. If A is 1, then NOT A will be 0, like that. Let me show a small example. So this is the table. Let me explain you the logical AND, OR, and logical NOT working. Logical AND, when is it true? When both the variable A and B, 0 is for false and 1 is for true over here. When both of them are true, at that time only the result will be true. If not, it will be false. So in this case, it is 0 over here. The next case, 0 and 1. A is 0 and B is 1. Here the resultant will be 0 again, because logical AND will be true only when both the variables are true. Here in this case, A is 1 and B is 0. So the result will be 0. And finally, when both are true, at that time the result is true. Alright. Now, the next case, logical OR. When does it work? A and B, both of them are zeros, so the result will be automatically 0. Next case, A is 0 and B is 1. Any one of them are true, OR will work as positive, and that is true. So A is true and B is 0. The result is 1. And finally, when both of them are true, the result is true. Now coming to the last and not the least, NOT A, reverse of A. If A is 0, A will be 1 over here. Next case, if A is 0, then the result will be 1. Next case, if A is 1, the result will be 0. And fourth case, when A is 1, the result will be 1. Sorry, 0. Reverse of it. Similarly, now B, NOT B, how does it work? NOT B, reverse of B, when b is 0, the result is 1, not b. When b is 1, the result is 0. When b is 0, the result is 1. When b is 1, the result is 0. Okay, so this is the case for logical AND and logical OR operator, right? Now let me go with the C program. So here we have seen the logical operator and the relational operator. Let us go to the C program now. So this is a C program where we have written, first included the header files, then the main program. Variables we have considered A, B, and D. Now applying the logical and the relational operators together. So how are we applying it is with the help of the condition, if and else condition, if and else block. Here I'm testing the condition for three variables A, B, and D. If A is greater than B and A is greater than D, if when A is being tested with B and D, then automatically the result declaration of A will be evaluated with both the other variables. In that case, A will be the greatest one. The other case else, if B greater than D, so at that time, if B is greater, if this case is true, at that time we can print a statement that is B is greatest. And the finally, if none of them are true, then finally the resultant third variable will be the greatest one. Let me see, show the execution of this one. So here we have zero errors and warnings. I've already executed once. Now, so the outcome of this one is like this. Okay, so here we got a value as D is greatest. As you have seen, A was 100, B was 200, and D was 300, right? So in this case, the greatest is the D value, D variable. Right, so greatest is D. Now, this was the logical and the relational. Let us go with the bitwise now. Now, coming to the bitwise operators, bitwise operators perform manipulation of the data at bit level. Okay, we know that in computers, all the data is being stored with bits only, zeros and the ones combination, right? So let me tell you how this bitwise operator works. We have bitwise AND, bitwise OR, bitwise XOR, and bitwise NOT operator, right? So let us see bitwise left shift and right shift. So we have an example over here with the truth table. We have the combination of AB as two variables where A is false for two times and true for two times. B is false for once, true for the second, third it is false again, and fourth time it is again true. So in that case, bitwise AND, how does it work? Bitwise AND exactly works in the same way how logical AND works. Means when both the values, both the variables are true, then only the result is true. So you can see over here, the last two cases of A and B, if when both of them are true, then only the bitwise AND is working, it is true. Now coming to the bitwise OR pipe symbol, it works exactly the same as logical OR. If any one of them, either A or B, is true, then the result is true. If both of them are false, then the result is false. So it is working exactly the same way. When both of them are zero, the result is zero. If any one of them is true, the result is true. Now coming to the XOR, A XOR B. When is it true? It is true when both A and B are exactly opposite to each other. Okay, they both must not be the same value. They both must not be true. They both must not be false. They must be, one of them must be true, one of them must be false. Then only the bitwise XOR is true. So you can say in the case 2 and case 3, when A is 0 and B is 1, then the result of A XOR B is 1. In the next case, when A is 1 and B is 0, at that time the result is 1. In the rest of the two cases, when both of them are exactly identical to each other, the result is 0. So this is your bitwise operators. Let us go with an example now. So in the bitwise operators, I have already written a program for you for easily explanation so that I can complete my explanation as early as possible. So here for explaining the bitwise AND, I have considered different variables over here as x1, x2, x3 and x4, y1, y2, y3 and y4. So x works the same way as A has worked just now in our example, and Y works exactly the same way as B has worked. And Z, I am storing for the result to display the resultant data. Now, coming to the working, means how I have explained you just now with the help of the table representation. This same representation, it is going to appear to you in your program in this form. Okay, so what are we doing first? X1 and Y1, bitwise AND operator is being considered between X1 and Y1 when both of them are 0. You know exactly bitwise AND works. Let me execute this and compare with the output and explain it then. It would be much more clear and understandable. So here we go. When both X1 and Y1 are 0, the result is 0. When X2 is 0 and Y2 is 1, at that time also the result is 0 in bitwise AND condition. When X3 and Y3 of both of them are opposite to each other, 1 and 0, at that time the result of bitwise AND is also again 0. Finally, in the last case, when both X4 and Y4 are 1, then the result is 1. Now, coming to the bitwise OR, how does it work? It works the same way as I have explained you in my explanation. When any one of them are true, then the result is true. If none of them is true at that time only, the result is false. So here in this case, only the first case is false and the rest of the three cases are true cases. Now coming to the bitwise XOR, how does it work? It works exactly the opposite way of AND. I can say here, when both of them X and Y are opposite to each other, means one is true and the other is false, at that time the result is true. And the other cases, when both of them are identical to each other, at that time the result is 0. So this is our bitwise operators in C language. Now let me show you all of them, all the operators together in one slot. Let us go with all types of operators of C language. So yesterday we have done with the arithmetic operators. Here I have combined all of them together. Now here you have the logical and the relation. Just now we have seen that. Coming to the assignment is nothing but assigning a value. So here, what am I doing? I'm assigning the value of A as D. So now it will consider the value of D, A as 30. Okay, after this execution. Now I am appending and also there minus, sorry, not an addition, subtraction, multiplication, and as well as we are seeing the increment and the decrement operator as well. Meaning of increment is adding plus one value to the existing value of the variable, and decrementing is adding minus one to the variable. Okay, so we have again subdivisions of increment and decrement, post increment and pre increment. Post in the sense when the value is printed, after the printing of the value will be incremented, and pre increment before the printing of the value gets incremented. Similar is the case with the post decrement and pre decrement. After the value gets printed, that time the value gets decremented. Before the value gets printed, the value gets decremented over here. Now, the last and the final case that I would like to explain in today's session is about the ternary operator. What is meant by ternary? Ternary is nothing but so these are the assignment operators of C language when we are assigning the value of A as B. So A is equal to B. We are assigning here, we are not testing the equality. In C language, for equality, you have double equality symbol. Then we have A plus is equal to B. So this I have shown you in the example just now. Let me show that same example in the output as well. I did not run the output. Now coming to the conditional operators, that is ternary operator. Let me first explain you what is ternary. Ternary operator is exactly the same way of if and else. Okay, if and else statement, conditional statement. So here the syntax, something goes with question mark and colon operator. So first expression is given, then after the question mark, the first condition, the first expression, that is a true expression will be printed. If this is not the case, the false expression will be printed. So here is a diagrammatic representation of the ternary operator. First, the given variable is there. Okay. Variable will be assigned to an expression 1. When this expression is true, at that time expression 2 will be printed. Okay, if this is false, at that time expression 3 will be printed. If whatever the will be the resultant, it will be stored in the variable. So let us go with the same example now. This output I have not executed, evaluated. So let me just go with the output. So this is the way how we got the arithmetic operators, the logical and the relational operators, assignment operator, and increment and decrement. Now coming to the ternary operator. So in the ternary operator, we do the same way as we first include the header files, then we go with the after this I consider there two variables A comma B. Okay, A is assigned a value as 10 and B is assigned a value as 20. Now after this, let me consider my void main section. This is the main section without which the program will not be executed. Here we need to give the expression first, that is my condition if A greater than B. If this is the case, then what we need to do, we need to printf. What are we going to do? Printf. backslash n will be used for the new line. Our new line a is greatest. Okay, if this is not the case, so at that time we will go with the else part, and there we print as printf. B is greatest, and finally the end of the statement. So this is the ternary operator. First of all, the expression will be there. When the expression is true, the true statement after the question mark will be printed. The false statement after the colon will be printed. Let me evaluate this. So I have saved my program as ternary.c. Now, you got the value output as b is greatest. Why? Because the value of b is 20. Okay, so that's the reason. It is exactly the same way how we write our if and else conditions. Hope today's session is clear with all the types of operators. And after this, we have now coming to the special operators. So these are the leftover special operators of C language, that is size of operator, ampersand which will return the address, and asterisk which will return a value with the pointer variable, right? So thank you so much for today's session.